Hey everybody and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet the bobble stitch. Now this bobble stitch has got fantastic funky texture on the front but has a beautifully flat back, making it quite a practical stitch, particularly for blankets. It is built over four rows, which gives you these nice offset bobbles. So without any further ado, let's leap straight on in to the tutorial. To begin, pop a slip knot onto your hook. Now the pattern multiple for this bobble stitch is 4 plus 3. Now all that means is you're going to chain in multiples of 4, 4, 4, 4, 4 until your project is as wide as you want it to be, then add 3 chains right at the very end. I'm only going to be crocheting a small sample today, so I'm going to go ahead and chain 23, which is my multiple of 4 plus 3. Once you have the correct amount of chains, we're going to begin by working into the 4th chain from our hook. So you don't count this loop that's on the hook, only these completed chains. So counting backwards, 1, 2, 3, we're going to place our first stitch into the 4th one here. And into that 4th chain, place a double crochet stitch. Then place a double crochet in each of the remaining chains along the row. Repeat this all the way to the end. So to begin row 2, chain 1 and turn your work. Place a single crochet in that exact same stitch where you just chained from. Single crochet in the next stitch. And then we're going to work our first bobble stitch into this 3rd stitch along. Now a bobble stitch is double crochet 5 together. So yarn over, go into that stitch, pull up a loop, you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2, and then stop. You have half a stitch hanging from your hook. We need 5 of those in total. So that's 1. Pop those 2 loops to the end, ignore those, and begin again. Yarn over, go into that same stitch, draw up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, and then stop. So that's 2. Ignore those 3 loops and begin again. Yarn over, go back into that same stitch and draw up a loop, yarn over, and pull through 2. Stop. So I've now got 3 double crochets half finished hanging from my hook. So just 2 more, slide those other loops down. You don't need those. Yarn over, go back into the same stitch, yarn over and drop a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, stop, and then 1 more time, yarn over, go back into that stitch, drop a loop, yarn over, and pull through 2. You'll have 5 half-finished stitches hanging from your hook and 6 loops on your hook. To complete the double crochet 5 together, we're going to yarn over and draw through all 6 loops. Now with your thumb, push it forwards, which forms your little bobble on the back. Now to secure your bobble stitch down, place a single crochet in the next stitch. Single crochet in 2 more of those stitches, so we want 3 in total, counting that same one that secured down your bobble. And now repeat the bobble stitch again. So double crochet, 5 together. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Once you have 5 half completed stitches hanging from your hook and 6 loops on your hook, yarn over and draw them all together. Then single crochet in the next 3 stitches and use your thumb to just push that bobble forwards. So secure it down with a single crochet in the next 3 stitches. We're going to repeat this all the way along the row. Bobble stitch in the next stitch and single crochet in the 3 after that. Bobble stitch, single crochet in the 3 after that. Keep going down the row. Once you finish your final bobble of the row, you'll notice there is only room for 2 single crochets rather than the 3 that you've been doing in the middle. That's absolutely fine. You want to end with a single crochet in the next stitch and then 1 into the top of your turning chain, those skipped chains right from the very beginning of row 1. So just pop a single crochet in there too. So for this row, you started and ended with 2 single crochets, and in the middle, in between your bobbles, you have 3. You will always have 3 single crochets in between your bobble stitches in the middle of your row. The only thing that changes is the number of single crochets that you start and end with on each row. So for row 2, start and end with 2 single crochets with your bobble stitch and 3 single crochets in between. For row 3, chain 2. This chain 2 does not count as a stitch. Turn your work so your bobbles are now facing you and double crochet into that exact same stitch where you just chained from. Double crochet in that second single crochet from the row below. And then double crochet into the top of your bobble stitch. Now, if you rotate your bobble stitch slightly, you'll see this elongated V here, right at the very top. So that's where you want to pop your double crochet. I'm just catching those 2 loops on top of my bobble stitch. Double crochet in your single crochet stitches. And then double crochet into the top of your bobble. Do this all the way along. Double crochet in the single crochet stitches and in the top of your bobbles. For row 4, chain 1 and turn. That chain 1 does not count as a stitch. Place a single crochet right in that very same stitch where you just chained from. And in the next 3 double crochet stitches. So for row 4, we're starting with 4 single crochet. This is what offsets your bobble stitches. Then bobble stitch in the next. Don't forget to push them forward for maximum bobble and secure them down with a single crochet in the next 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3. Bobble, single crochet in 3. Bobble, single crochet in 3. Do this bobble stitch followed by 3 single crochet right the way across the row. Once you reach the other side, you'll notice that you have 4 stitches remaining. Remember, this turning chain, the chain 2, does not count. So instead of doing it into 3, 1, 2, 3, we started the row with 4 single crochet. So we're going to end with 4 as well. So your very last stitch will be into the top of the double crochet, ignoring your chain 2. So for row 4, you start and end with 4 single crochets and you have your groups of 3 in the middle. For row 5, chain 2 and turn your work. Now we're back onto the bobbly side and you can see how they are offset from each other. For this row is a repeat of row 3. So double crochet into this very first stitch where you just chained from, and double crochet in all your single crochet stitches and the top of your bobble stitches right the way across the row. At the end of this row, I'll also show you how to change color in case you wanted a stripy effect for your blanket. So if you wanted to change colour at the end of any row, I'll show you on this one. Before I do this last stitch, to change colour, you simply do the final yarn over of the stitch with your new colour. So I'll demonstrate on this double crochet because they're slightly more tricky than changing colour on a single crochet. But to change colour, if you wanted to, we're going to yarn over, go into that last stitch, draw up a loop, 3 loops, yarn over, pull through 2. And then before you do this final yarn over to complete the stitch, we're going to go ahead and bring in our new color. Leave a decent tail so you can weave it in later. Loop that over your hook and just draw it through. So then you are ready to begin your next row in your different color. Let's just snip off this yellow here so it's not attached. So from this point on, you're simply going to repeat rows 2, 3, 4, and 5 for as long as you want your project to be. I'll do a tiny little recap for you now. To start again, we'd be going back to row 2, which was chain 1 and turn, and start with a single crochet in the first 2 stitches. Then you begin your sequence of bobble stitch, single crochet in 3, bobble stitch, single crochet in 3, all the way along. And you end this second row, row 2, with 2 single crochets right at the very end. Row 3, chain 2 and turn, and you simply double crochet in every single stitch, including the top of the bobble stitches, all the way across. To recap row 4, chain 1, turn, and start with 4 single crochets. Then it's bobble, single crochet in 3, bobble, single crochet in 3, all the way along. And because we started with 4 single crochet, we're going to end with 4. And the repeat of row 5, chain 2 and turn, and double crochet in every single stitch and on top of your bobbles. To end your very final stitch, so imagine this is as large as you want your project to be. For your very last stitch, once you've completed it, chain 1, snip your yarn, leaving a length to weave in afterwards, pull that hook up and out, and then pull this tight. That won't hold it forever, but it holds it long enough for you to then go ahead and weave in your ends. If you'd like to learn how I weave in my ends, then click this video right here. And until next time, happy crocheting. Bye.